you have something you want God to change in your life? Because many people don't know why they are living. If you know why you are living, you will not be living wrongly. You will not be making the same mistake over and over, over and over. One is mistake, two is mistake, the third one is foolishness. Hallelujah. Amen. Yesterday I was sharing with you on the spiritual life. That was my message yesterday, spiritual life. And I said that is the life of Christian ought to live. You are born again, the life Jesus gave to you is a spiritual life. This is the reason why you must not compare your life with a non-believer's life. Many of you today, you no longer running your race. You are no longer living your life. You are living people's life. The same shirts they buy, you buy. They buy the same trousers, you buy. They buy the same naked clothes, you buy. What is the difference between unbeliever and Christian? Be different. Tell them about
be different.
Have pattern. Let people know you. When you come out, let people see the glory of God in you. The man you are representing is not an ordinary man, Jesus. You are representative of Jesus. So anywhere you find yourself, always remember that you are representing somebody. You are standing for somebody. Be careful how you live your life as a Christian. This is the reason why all of you attract sickness, demon, problem to yourself today. Am I talking to somebody? Now you don't even know how to come out of the problem now. Most of you, only one problem that comes to your life, you expatiate the problem. Instead of you to change it, you not damage it, you not enlarge it, you not became worse. Little problem that come to amend you, little problem that come to correct you, little problem that come to instruct you, little problem that come to direct you, you not turn into affliction. Not to cover you. No, today whatever hiding you must come out. Yeah. I didn't hear your amen. Yeah. Be careful how you are going out about your problem. How you solve your problem matter. Where you get your testimony matter. Testimony is not the issue. The issue is the life after the testimony. The life after testimony, after you get testimony, you are nowhere to be found in the church. Is that testimony? That is a trap. The life after testimony, the Bible says, fight the good fight of faith. He said, lay hold on eternal life. Let me hear your mighty name, amen.
Yeah.
This morning, what I want to share with you is spiritual growth. Spiritual growth. Why? Because it's possible for you to be spiritual and you are not growing. The same Jesus you received 10 years ago is the same Jesus you are still holding today. You are not growing. That is how many Christians are today. The same Jesus they received 15 years ago, you are still holding the same Jesus. Does that mean your children are not growing? How come your Jesus is not growing? Let me hear your mighty name,
amen.
All your children finish university, you will still remain only that small Jesus you receive. If any man be in Christ, a new creature, only that small you receive is what you are still holding. God believe in growth. God wants his children to grow. The first area in which you must grow after you give your life to Christ is your spiritual life. That is the first area you need to prosper and grow. The first prosperity you need is spiritual growth. If you are rich physically, financially, and you are poor spiritually, you are not rich. That richness will not last. You are rich physically and your spiritual life is poor. It's just a matter of time, you will still go down. Do you know why? There is no foundation, no solid foundation. Am I talking to somebody? If I'm talking to you, let me hear your mighty name. Amen. That is the first place you need to prosper and grow your spiritual life. The Bible says, grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you are a Christian without knowledge, you will always be broken. You will always be victimized. If you are a Christian and you are not growing, you will always be a victim. Isaiah, the book of Isaiah said it. He said, my people come astray, they come into captivity because of lack of knowledge. This is what the Christians are facing today. It's not the devil, it's lack of knowledge. They are born again, yet they don't know who they are. If you give your life to Christ, first thing you need to do is to start building yourself. Your inner man, you need to build it. Am I talking to somebody? Refuse to be poor spiritually. God wants you to be strong. Enable you to live the life in this earth. God wants his children to be more strong. Every day of your life, build your life, develop your Christianity. Am I talking to somebody? Enlarge your capacity. In order you be able to handle your destiny, you need to enlarge your capacity. If you have a small strength, you cannot handle the life. The Bible says, if you faint in the days of adversity, he said your strength is small. Many of you are so weak. You are looking for deliverance, but there is no strength. You are looking for healing, but there is no strength. When you lack knowledge, you are like a blind man. You think blindness is a man that doesn't see, he sees. All he can see is darkness. A blind man sees. All he can see is what? Darkness. Blindness is not a man that cannot see. It's a man that can see. But all he can see, he could see, is what? Darkness. There are spiritual blind men and women. They are blind spiritually. They can't see far. All they can see is trouble. What are the things you can see? If you cannot see far, it means you are spiritually blind. Anyway, you are blind spiritually. I open your eyes this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let me hear that amen, somebody. A blind man is not the one that cannot see. He sees. But all he could see is what? Darkness. How come you are not growing? The same Jesus you received 10 years ago is the same Jesus you are still talking to today. Let me hear the mighty name of God. Today you will not go back the same way you come. The first thing you need as a Christian is knowledge. You need knowledge to know what you are supposed to do, to know where you are going, and to know who you are serving. God grows every day. Revelation of God changes every day. You need new revelation. Leave that class you have been for many years. Many of you, you have been in class 1 for 20 years. Why can't you graduate? Why can't you move? God wants his children to move from one class to another. From one class to another. From one class to another. That is prosperity. That is growth. That is what God is looking for in your life. Am I talking to somebody? Don't remain in one class for so long. Refuse to remain in one place. As a Christian, learn to grow in your prayer life, in your study life, every area of your life. Fasting, learn to grow. Develop yourself. 45 years old man complain like a baby. Tired of this one. Die. Get to know what to do again. You that don't know what to do, why are you looking for prosperity? Prosperity will kill you until you know what to do. Am I talking to somebody? Yes. This is the reason why you need strength. Dynamic ability. You need strength to control the earth. You need strength to serve God. You need strength. If you have no strength as a Christian, everything around you will cease to be affliction, attack. If they correct you in church, attack. If they instruct you, attack. If you have no knowledge of God, everything around you will cease to what? To be an attack. Are you aware there are problems that come to pull you out of low level to higher level? There are problems that come to move you by force. Mostly if you are comfortable in where you are, and God is expecting you to move out of your comfort zone, God will allow a certain trouble to come around you to pull you out by force. But if you have not the knowledge of God, you cannot comprehend that. You cannot understand it. There are troubles that come to prepare you for prosperity. There are troubles that come to prepare you for promotion. There are troubles that come to train you to be a hard man. Am I talking to somebody?
Yeah.
Before a soldier is being promoted, you first of all undergo another training. Before you enter soldier, watch them on your social media. You see they will put them inside water. As they are swimming in the water, they are beating the hell out of them. Why? They want them to get used to beating. They flog them, they beat them. They want them to get used to beating. They tell them to jump down from up so that they will be strong as a soldier. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
This program is to recreate you. Every weakness in you will change. Any area of your life you have been sleeping, you will wake up. That is the meaning of this program, brothers and sisters. Refuse to be spiritually weak. The first place to prosper is your spiritual life. You are a married man, you don't have days for fasting. Are you aware marriage is a ministry? Are you aware business is a ministry? Anything that brings money is a ministry. Let me hear your amen. You're a married man, you're a married woman. You don't have time for prayer. You don't have quiet time. All the time you have is busy time. And you're telling God to show up. There's no conducive environment for God to show up. You are always busy. And God is telling you, stop, create time for me. I'm going to show up. Create time. No, you are busy. You are busy. You are busy. Look at when Jacob was looking for deliverance. The Bible says after he sent out his servant, God appeared. God needs a quiet place. Am I talking to somebody? Most of the things you are going through, God is telling you, small daughter, give me chance. Give me chance to reign in your life. They are not trouble. He's telling you, give me chance. But because of your lack of knowledge, you don't know what is happening. You are looking for deliverance. Are you aware many of you sitting here? It's not deliverance you need. You need knowledge. How can you be carrying Bible? You don't know what you're carrying. It's a pity these days now we don't carry Bible. It's laptop. It's what they call iPad and handset. You say it's Bible or both. Spiritual knowledge. Growth. Are you aware? If you are not growing spiritually, God cannot do much with you. If you are not growing spiritually, God cannot do much with you. There are things God wants to communicate to you as a child. Because of your lack of knowledge, immaturity, He can't reveal them, He can't communicate it to you because you are too soft, you are too weak. There are many things God wants to communicate to you about the next level, about your future, about the next class. But because of your inability to carry it, because of your weakness, because of your baby character, God cannot communicate it because of you are weak. Am I talking to somebody here this morning? If I told you, let me hear your amen. God wants to communicate new things to you. God wants to give you new information. But you are not ready. You are not strong. You are not ready to collect it. In this church you are seeing, there was a time I finished the program, early morning program. The people that came, they were not to cease. They were not all to cease. But because I can see far, I will not move. I believe increase is coming. I believe God is saying something in my life. But many of you are easily discouraged. Why? Because you are not spiritually grounded. I pray May the knowledge of God be built in your heart.
Amen.
If you are a Christian, you don't have knowledge, you will not go far. Everything will be like an offense to you. When pastor talk, you say they report me. When pastor preach, they report me. Why? Because you are in charge. If God opened many of your eyes here to show you the class you have been since you give your life to Christ, you'll be crying for yourself. Many of you here, you have been in primary one since you give your life to Christ. You are not planning to move to primary two. You are just there. And you are looking for people that will draw to primary one also. Have you ever seen such people when they receive shame, they are looking for victory? Grow, tell me about grow. Learn to grow. Grow in your mind. Grow in your heart. Grow in your spirit. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
You need to build yourself, become more stronger. The devil will be afraid of you. You think it's prayer you use to conquer devil? It's not prayer, it's knowledge. It's not prayer you use to conquer devil. It's knowledge. Because after prayer, they are still coming back again. Am I talking to somebody? When you say demon out, here we go. But it's coming back again. In the book of Luke, when Satan was wrestling with Jesus, did Jesus use prayer? No. Satan appeared. He knew that Jesus was hungry. And Satan speak and said, he spoke. He said, if you know you are a son of God, change this stone to be bread. Number one, Satan blackmailed why Jesus is a son of God. He didn't just know, he is a son of God. Another one, change stone to become bread. Stone is stone, bread is bread. And Jesus was wise enough. What was his response? Man does not live by bread alone. That was knowledge. That wasn't prayer. Was that prayer? This is the reason why you need knowledge of God. This is the reason why you need to grow. Man does not live by bread, meaning it's not only food we eat. We eat by the word of God. Man does not live by bread alone, but every word that comes out of the mouth of God is what we live by. You need knowledge to live, brothers and sisters. By this program, you go home, your daughter or your son first sick. You don't need to cry. Apply knowledge, brothers and sisters. The reason why the devil show up, he become prosperity has come to your house. Apply knowledge. You don't need to shout. You don't need to cry. Upon all the fasting and prayer, upon all the deliverance, why this problem? Who told you devil will not come again? He will always come. That is the reason why you need to be strong. Say, I'm strong. Say, the strength of God is at work in me. Say it again. Say, the strength of God is at work in me. Say, I refuse to be weak. I am strong inside. I have wisdom. I have knowledge. I have understanding. I refuse to remain in one place. Say, from today, I have spiritual strength. I am growing spiritually. I refuse to be a baby. I am a strong man. Shout yourself, I'm a strong man. You need strength, brothers and sisters. Thank you, Jesus. Say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Ephesians chapter 3. As a Christian, when you open mouth to pray in public, it's once we know how strong are you. Anytime you talk, we will know the level you are in Christ. Father, help me. You are a child. Help me. Everything that they help you, every year help. You think God is happy with you like that? Your son, 1 year, 2 years, 10 years, is still telling you, help me. Mommy, help me. I need biscuits. 15 years, mommy, buy me biscuits. You will be happy as a mother, as a father. Also, the same way God is not happy with you when you are not growing spiritually. when you open mouth to pray or to talk, we will know your level in Christ. Have mercy on me. Save me. I cover my life with the blood of Jesus. You are a child. The blood of Jesus is inside of you. Anything that is inside, you don't even need to use to cover it. It's already there. It's so pure already. Father, I pray for my family. Protect us. Protect my father. Protect my mother. And bless us. You are a child. That is all you can see. Your father and your mother. You cannot see church. You don't know how to pray for the world. You cannot pray for the whole world. Father, I'm taking over the whole world. You don't pray like that. I take over every nation. I take over states. Doors are open to me in every country. No. Father, as I'm going out today, I cover my life with the blood of Jesus. Shame on you. You need to grow. Grow. Tell people, grow.
Grow.
Increase your faith. Let us see far. Don't talk based on what is going on around you. See far. The Bible says the earth is of the Lord and the fullness thereof. God has given you the whole world already. It's how much you can take. Tell people like that. I didn't hear you. Tell people, God has given you the whole world. What is how much you can take? How much of God can you carry? Or how much of God do you have in you? If you want to talk now, borrow me money. It's once we will know that you are a primary one. The way you talk. You don't know how to use faith. You always apply your sight. The Bible says the just shall live by faith, not by sight. For many of you, you live by sight. Borrow me money. Help me. I don't borrow money. I don't borrow. If I call you, send money to my account. That is why I off my phone. You must send that money. Tell me what you want to send now. If I'm traveling, I need 200,000. I don't call. It's send money to my account. That is how they just live. Not a bet. Borrow you money. You borrow me money. You borrow money, money. Oh my God. I mean money. You don't borrow money, money. Am I talking to somebody? Apply faith to all you do. They just live by faith. He said, but if anyone look back, my soul shall not have pleasure upon him. He said, for we are not of those that look back unto destruction. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38. Everything that comes out of the mouth, make sure it meets with faith. Don't fear, speak faith. You are going out in the morning, you have no money, call car, call for car. For money. Lord, I'm going out. I have no money in my pocket, but I am going out in the name of Jesus. Somebody will just drive and say, are you going to town? Enter.
Hallelujah.
That going to Mother Land Joshua and start jumping from back of bus. Inside boots, I enter the bus. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Spiritual growth. We know those that are growing spiritually. We know those that are growing spiritually. We know children. Verse 16, where I said we should open Ephesians chapter 3. Are we there?
Yeah.
Verse 16, I read, that he will grant you according to the riches of his glory. To what? To be strengthened with what? With mind in where? In his spirit in where? In the inner man. That is what I'm talking about. In the inner man, not outside. To be stretched in the inside. It's even better you are strong inside than to be strong outside. There are many of you here, you are so big, but your inside is so tiny. He said that he will grant you according to the riches of his glory to be stretched with mind in the spirit, in the inner man. How is your inner man? Are you aware there is something inside of you that always tell you there is danger ahead of you? Are you aware that there is something inside of you that always tells you what to do and what not to do? There is something inside of you. That is what I'm talking about. That is the thing you need to build. That is the real you, not the outside. Many of you say, one of my mind said I should not go. That is not your mind. That is the God inside of you. That is the place you should focus on. That it will grant you according to the riches of His glory. To be strengthened with mind by His Spirit in the inner man. Verse 17. That Christ may dwell in your heart by what? By faith, that ye being what? Rooted and what? And grounded in love.
Hallelujah.
Be rooted and grounded in love. This is talking about strength, spiritual strength. That Christ may dwell in your heart by faith, that you being rooted and grounded in love. I pray for somebody. May that strength in you be more grounded in the name of Jesus. When something bad is happening to you, refuse to fear. All you need to do, let the glory of God rise within you, brothers and sisters. The glory of God will not come upon you. It will rise within you. Many of you say, let the glory of God cover me. The glory don't cover. It can only rise. Who will rise that glory is you. Am I talking to somebody? Anytime you are facing danger, you are facing trouble, let the glory of God rise within you. Am I talking to somebody? He said, arise, shine, for the light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen within you. Let me hear your mighty name as somebody. Let the glory rise within you. You don't need to cry. You don't need to murmur. You don't need to complain. There is something inside of you. Jesus is within you, brothers and sisters. You have said Jesus is inside of you. He's not coming from the sky. He's coming from within you. Christ in you is the hope of glory. I can see something inside of you. That trouble in you is changing this morning. Jesus is inside of you. Am I talking to somebody? Refuse to fear. No matter what you see, refuse to fear. We don't move by what you see. We don't move by what you hear. We only move by the word of God. Let me hear your mighty name. Is something in you. That is why I'm telling you to build. Have a solid foundation. Build your God so strong. Why demons are so close to many of you? Because your God is so small. If you eat the dream, it's not a problem to you. It's not a problem to you. May mark your body, it's not a problem to you. The Bible tells you they will not mark your body. He said they will surely gather against you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
But your reaction to that dream will not turn to affliction. Your reaction to a dream will turn to affliction. Your reaction, you dream that you eat your dream. Yes, actually defend you. But God is aware of it. You now enter the bedroom and start choking your you want to vomit it out now. We live by faith, not by sight. The food they gave you was not physical food, it was spiritual. God will remove it spiritually.
Yeah.
Let me hear your mighty name. Amen.
Yeah.
You hear somebody say they will suck your blood. Let them come and suck my blood. They will suck it on a poison.
Yeah.
Have knowledge. Have strength. Have boldness. Be mature for God to be used. God wants to use you, but you are not ready. Be mature for God to be you. The Bible says in the great house there is not only a vessel of gold but of silver and of wood. He said for Saul to be honored and Saul to be dishonored. Humble yourself for God to be honored.
Amen.
Let God use you. There are many things God wants to use you to do, but you are not strong. When God called Moses to go to Pharaoh to say, let my people go, Moses will try to change God's mind. I said, God, you know I cannot talk well with my mother. Did God know before? Who created you? Is it not God? God said, I will put something in your tongue. He said, I cannot go, I don't know how to talk well. Send Aaron. Did God know that Aaron was there? I'm asking everybody. You are trying to correct God. Just be willing. Leave the rest for God. Isaiah said, if you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. Your willingness and your obedience, you will take over the land. Your willingness and your obedience. When Moses obeyed, he conquered Pharaoh.
Hallelujah.
Am I talking to somebody?
Yes,
you just obey. Build your inner mind, brothers and sisters. He said that he will crown you according to the riches of his glory to be strengthened with mind. In where? In your inner man. To be strengthened with mind. This is what God wants you to live. This is how God wants you to live. To be strong. Trouble is going on, you are not moved. Your house is on fire, you are not moved. There is hunger, you are not moved. Strength is in you. Say strength is in me. Say Christ in me is the hope of glory. Say I refuse to be weak in life. Say it again, say I refuse to be weak in life. Verse 17 again. That Christ may dwell in your heart by faith, that you be rooted and grounded in love. Verse 18. May be able to comprehend. With what? With all saints. What is the breadth and length and depth and height? And to know the love of Christ which passeth knowledge, that ye might be filled with what? With all the fullness of God. Let me hear your amen.
Amen.
May be able to comprehend. He said, build your strength so that you'll be able to understand. You'll be able to understand with everybody. That is why many of you here, you don't know how to live with people. You cannot accommodate people. Why? Because you are not strong. He said, may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth, the deep, the height, and the length. Let me hear your mighty name.
Amen.
If this strength is in you, you will be able to comprehend with everybody. Anywhere you enter, you can live with them. There are many of you, you cannot accommodate. When somebody call your house to visit you now, they ask which day they go. Until they go today. Because you are tired of it, you don't know how to accommodate people. I can accommodate madman. I have knowledge to live with a madman. I have knowledge to live with blind man. I have knowledge to live with everybody but you. It's only you, even you cannot even live with yourself. As long as you can separate your leg, you can even separate it. That Christ may dwell in your heart by faith. Say, Christ is dwelling in my heart. Say, Christ is dwelling in my heart. Say, from today I am strong. I will no longer be weak. From today I know what to say. I know what to do. And I know what not to do. I will not get confused again. I have knowledge. I have strength. Say, from today, I will never get confused again. I hear many of you say, I'm just confused, huh? Spirits don't get confused, though. We are spirits. If I confuse, who will pastor this church? If I confuse, who will pastor this church? I plan ahead of my members. I plan ahead of my workers. When they are taking the old, me, I'm taking new one.
Amen.
That is why if I hear demons say they'll kill me, they'll use so-and-so. I want to change the person already. If I hear them say they will use so-and-so, they kill me, I'll be laughing in my heart because I already plan to change the person. You can't catch me. If you are expecting me with motor, I'll use leko.
Na sua de work out spiritual. Just see me with a polo, I just stroke on. You even pass me by the gate. Say, this one will be man of God. It is a man of God. And I say, small. I'll pass you in that church.
Pray for you.
Receive me. Say, I pray for you.
Receive
strength in the name of Jesus. You will not fail in the name of Jesus. You will not die in the name of Jesus. You will not go back in the name of Jesus. What your father and your mother could not do, you are the one to do it. Where they could not reach, listen to me, plan to pass. Strength. Strength. Wave your hands, say thank you, Jesus. Wave your hands, say thank you, Jesus. God bless you all. That is the end of my message.